Duke is not the only nickname I've had or enjoyed. Because I was such a good second baseman, I was nicknamed Otto after the great Otto Williams. That was the first of a long string of sobriquets. Doc Perry called me Wucker, and Sonny Greer, who brought me to New York and told me not to look at the high buildings, called me the Kid. Juan Tizol's wife called me Apple Dumpling. Cootie Williams' wife called me Dumpling. And Johnny Hodges' wife called me Dumpy. It was Louie Bellson who started calling me Maestro. Louis Bellson is so handsome a cat that when he's on the stand, the chicks don't see anybody but him. Louis is truly a beautiful person with the soul of a saint.
When the maestro, Duke, it all happens with him. Now, when you look back at that band, when I first met them in 1940, 41, all the heavy players, so to speak, were there. Hodges, Ben Webster, Barney Bigard, Sonny Greer, Rex Stewart, all these fantastic players were there. Now, Duke, you know, he made the comment once. He said, when I'm playing piano and leading my band, he said, I'm listening all the time. And he was well aware of what every personality's range was. Like, in other words, when he wrote something for Ray Nance, he was very cautious not to write over a certain note over the staff. He knew the capabilities and the range of every individual, and therefore he wrote and distributed notes for those individuals. Now, he also found out what their solo capabilities were. So when he gave somebody wrote something for a person, it was designed specifically for that person. There was no question in his mind that this particular soloist was going to perform that number. He knew they would be able to do it because he had already sculled them out, so to speak. He knew exactly what they were able to do and what they were really capable of doing, where they were their best. And this, to me, takes a gigantic type of a man. It takes a typical guy who's really a band leader, and he was the ultimate as far as a band leader is concerned. Now, I can remember when I joined the band, there's no drum book. There was never any drum book. No, never any drum parts. When he orchestrated something, it was written for the five saxes, for the four trumpets, three trombones, and the bass part. He never made a piano part or a drum part. Now, if Strayhorn wrote something that Duke had to play, he still didn't write a piano part, but he played it over for Duke, and they had it all worked out so that when Duke played it, he had it up here, see. Now, for the drum part, you know, Sonny Greer was in that band for many, many, many years, and he automatically knew what to do. If it was a kind of a difficult piece, then he took his time and learned it. But he almost knew exactly what the band was going to do after being in there for so long. Now, with me coming into the band, naturally, the first thing I did was look for the drum book. And when I didn't see one, I thought, well, I think I know what's going to happen. They're going to rely completely on my intuition, and this is what Duke wants, you know. It may be a little rough the first week or two until I get to know the things and hear them for the first time, but I knew that Duke had an idea that he wanted me to really dig in and take my time learning the parts, especially on the concert dates where we don't play the dance music, where we get into the heavy things, the suites, things in two and three movements. And of course, I being able to read all kind of music, I looked over at Clark Terry's part, and I saw all these, like Harlem Suite, 12 pages long, and I'd walk up to Clark and I'd say, Clark, we're gonna play this, right? He says, oh yeah, you'll enjoy playing this, Lou. And I said, don't you wanna tell me something about the tempo change? Oh, don't worry about it, everything's great, you know. And six guys in the band told me this, you know, and then I went to Duke and he told me the same thing. So I thought, boy, they sure have a lot of faith in me, you know. But then finally Duke said, just watch me. I'll give you all the tempo changes and it'll be a little rough maybe the first couple of weeks, but after you get to know the things, he said, I know I'm not worried about a thing. You know, they were very relaxed about this, you know. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.